Hello everyone, this is my new Kew Mate 2012 RA, a true RMS multimeter with built-in test leads and open-type current sensor. It was made by the Japanese company Kyoritsu. It's rated at 120 amperes, 600 volts AC-DC. It's made in Kyoritsu's plant in Thailand. Almost all of the space at the back was dedicated to its specifications. Here is the Kew Mate 2012 RA multimeter. Instruction manuals in Japanese and English. The English instructions were quite comprehensive and clear. A certificate of conformity and a pair of AAA batteries. Now I have already installed the original Fujitsu batteries that came with it. I just placed my spare Toshiba batteries in the package for reference. Let me show you how the batteries are installed. This green thing around the instrument is called its holster, and it is a flexible rubber. The current sensor and the test leads are permanently attached, and they are reeled in on each side for safekeeping. Outside of its holster, the instrument is really very small and lightweight, and also very thin. These are the original batteries that came with the instrument. Fujitsu AAA batteries, made in Indonesia. The 2012 RA is the upgraded version of the previous 2012 R. This new version now has the reinforced rubber bushings, this pair of elbows here, and a white indicator in the function dial. This little white marker may be a small thing, but it's a convenient feature that I personally appreciate in any multimeter. In fact, if it's missing, I make my own, like what I did with the function dials on my Fluke 324 and Q-Snap 203. The model number 2012 RA also makes it easy to recall the maximum conductor size and current it can handle, 12 mm in diameter conductor and 120 amperes AC and DC current respectively. I don't have a 12 mm diameter conductor with me, but this Sharpie pen is approximately 12 mm in diameter. Let's slide this inside the open type current sensor to get some context. So a 12 mm conductor is just the right and exact fit in the space of the open type current sensor without being too tight or too loose. A large LCD screen occupies the top of the instrument. It has no backlight, but it features a big, bold 6000 count digital display which is easy to read. They also designed a digital bar graph to simulate an analog display, which is a nice touch. Switched off by turning the function dial to the middle. Notice that the functions are logically arranged. All measurements that require the test leads are at the right, exactly where the test leads are kept. Current measurements are placed on the left, where the open type current sensor is attached. The frequency function stands by on the left side too, waiting for AC voltage or AC current signals above 6 volts or 6 amperes. To freeze the display on screen, push the data hold button. The The yellow select button is used to toggle functions, indicated in yellow, and on the right side, these are resistance, diode, continuity, and capacitance tests. This is the function for AC voltage up to 600 volts, DC voltage up to 600 volts, resistance to 60 mega ohms, diode test with 2 volts DC, a very audible continuity buzzer that will sound off at a resistance below 35 ohms, give or take 25 ohms, and a capacitor tester that can measure up to 40 microfarads. At the left side, first up, we have the 120 ampere range AC-DC current. To choose either AC or DC, simply press the select button. Next, 60 ampere range AC-DC current. Frequency in Hertz will be displayed for AC voltage above 6 volts and AC current above 6 amperes. Below these numbers, frequency will not be displayed. This is the open type current sensor secured to the instrument with cord. At the handle of the current sensor, we have a button to reset the display to zero before we measure DC current. A single press will do it. And we know it's been reset because a small triangle or delta sign pops up on the display. The open jaws of the current sensor contain arrows used to position the conductor right and orienting them correctly for DC current measurements. The tips are gold-plated with removable safety covers. If you prefer larger, more robust clump meters, the 2012 RA may not be for you, but I appreciate the fact that it is available as a choice for those who might need a really compact true RMS multimeter with AC-DC current capabilities. Thank you for watching.